Lipoic acid. Does it need to be the R form? Hi, I'm Chris Masterjohn, and I have a PhD in nutritional sciences. I am not a medical doctor, and nothing contained in this episode may be construed as medical or nutritional advice of any kind or a substitute, therefore. This episode is meant purely as scientific education. If you wish to act on any ideas presented in this episode, please consult your physician first, and never take anything herein as a reason to contradict medical advice. With that said, enjoy the episode. Margaret Okazumi says, are you still taking R-lipoic acid? And could you comment on R-lipoic acid versus alpha-lipoic acid to help with lowering blood sugar levels and recovering from oxidative damage? I'm not currently taking R-lipoic acid. I did take it a couple times in the far distant past when I was having trouble making it in between meals. And I always used R-lipoic acid. More recently, I was taking it when I was taking high doses of pantothenic acid as an experiment, because that can interfere with biotin and lipoic acid absorption. And I'm not taking that now, so I'm not taking the lipoic acid either. But I do sometimes just periodically take all the B vitamins, and I will put lipoic acid in, because what I have in my cabinet for B5 happens to be 500 milligrams per capsule of pantothenic acid. And I will take biotin then too. And when I have taken R-lipoic acid to help between meals in the past, I would pair that with D-biotin and acetyl-L-carnitine. Lipoic acid can help with blood sugar, and it is an antioxidant. I would always use R-lipoic acid. I would never use the racemic mixture of alpha-lipoic acid, because the R form is the biologically active one. And I think it's it might be the case that you can just take a higher dose, but why mess around with the possibility that some isomer that doesn't belong in your body and isn't found in food isn't going to interfere with the function of the R form? So I would just take R-lipoic acid for any purpose at all. Thank you, Margaret, for your question.
This episode was part of a Q&A for members of the CMJ Masterpass, where I hold monthly private Zoom Q&As for my members. The Masterpass also serves as a buyer's club with exclusive and massive discounts on your favorite premium foods and health products, including pasture-raised and wild meat and seafood, supplements, sleep accessories, water filters, phototherapy devices, and much more. If you'd like to participate in these Q&As, you can join the Masterpass at chrismasterjohnphd.com/masterpass and use the code Q&A, spelled Q-A-N-D-A, Q&A, for 10% lifetime discount. I am currently working full-time on finishing my first book, Vitamins and Minerals 101, How to Get the Nutrients You Need on Any Diet. I will let you know when I have a release date. In the meantime, you can pre-order the book at chrismasterjohnphd.com/book. Testing Nutritional Status, The Ultimate Cheat Sheet, has been newly released as version 1.3. This is my comprehensive system for managing nutritional status with lab tests, dietary analysis, and comprehensive intake of your signs and symptoms. The new version has a comprehensive guide to interpreting the Genova methylation panel. You can pick up your copy at chrismasterjohnphd.com/cheat sheet. In my consulting, I am neither a medical practitioner nor a coach. I serve as your data analyst and your strategist. I teach you scientific principles of health and wellness, help you analyze your data, and help brainstorm actionable strategies. You can sign up for a consultation at chrismasterjohnphd.com/consultations. Please consider supporting my work at no extra cost to you by visiting my support page and making a purchase with one of my affiliate links. Some of my most popular affiliates are also listed in the description of this video, with links that will give me credit for your purchase. I will try to respond to comments when I can, but my presence will be intermittent while I'm finishing my book. I hope you enjoyed this, and I will see you in the next episode.